In the examples we experienced so far, a revolute joint was usually defined between two rigid bodies. In this lecture, we want to describe a new case where we see a revolute joint between three or even more rigid bodies. We will then have some examples to practice and learn how to deal with this case when computing the degrees of freedom in a system. Let's describe the case. Imagine we have a beautiful ground like this and two links pinned to the ground. We already know that the degrees of freedom in this system is two, these two independent rotations. Now let's apply the formulation. The degrees of freedom is 3 times number of bodies, which is obviously 2, minus 2 times J1. Now the question is, how many revolute joints we have here at this point? We see one support icon here, but in fact there are 2 joints there, one between this link and the ground, and another one between this link and the ground. And considering 2 revolute joints, the degrees of freedom is 4 minus 2, 2, which is the same answer we already knew. Let's have a closer look. Imagine we have 2 bodies pinned together. Now a third body pinned to them. How many revolute joints do you think should we count here? In fact, there is one revolute joint between this link and this one, and the second revolute joint between this link and this one. But we should not count one more between this one and this one, because it is not a new independent constraint. Now let's make a rule about this. If we have n links pinned together, we can count n minus 1 revolute joints. For example, here we have 5 convergent links and we should consider 4 revolute joints. That's it. And we can use this rule when computing the degrees of freedom in a system that includes convergent links. Let's have an example and determine the degrees of freedom in this system using the rule we have learned. The number of bodies is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 7. The number of revolute joints, here we should count only one revolute joint. That's also the case for here, so 1. At this joint, since we have 1, 2, 3 links, we count 2 revolute joints. Because according to the rule, if we have n links, we count n minus 1 joints. That's also the case for this joint, where we have 1, 2, 3 links, so 2 revolute joints here. And also this joint, 1, 2, 3 links, so 2 revolute joints here as well. Finally, here we have 2 links plus the ground, so again 3 links and we count 2 revolute joints. Therefore, as you see, J1 is 10 and the degrees of freedom is 3 times 7 bodies minus 2 times 10, so 1 degree of freedom for the system. Let's have another example where we have a slider. And also we see a new symbol here. This slider has a prismatic joint with this wall, which can be assumed as the ground. This symbol here means this part and this part are kind of welded, and from here to here is one rigid body as a whole. And this link is just pinned to it. So we count this as only one revolute joint. The number of bodies is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. The number of revolute joints, here between these two links and the slider, we count two revolute joints. Other than that, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, so 8 revolute joints in total, plus one prismatic joint here. Therefore, J1 is 9, and the degrees of freedom is 3 times 7 minus 2 times 9, which is 3.